be recording.
Oh, so
I'm recording. I don't need to touch anything. I ain't never
my phone is live. We don't lie. What we do, we wait till at least 10 people come in the building before we start talking our mess.
All right.
We've been doing this long enough. We know what I'm saying?
I'm more than 15. I'm begging for 15. We're 15 going to come to building with his cheese. I'm telling you. She's like the Jetson Giants.
That's enough, man. I don't know if I'm real
team. Oh, man. He's one of them. Yeah. Actually, you're a smart guy.
That's why I look so young.
Yeah, yeah, you're a smart guy. Keep your blood pressure down. That's the show. That's the truth. Yo, I watched the game Sunday. You know what I said?
This guy's on the bus. Yo, it's been a long time since I can sit down and do the game. I just got a chance to win a game.
I ain't worried about how much they're gonna lose, but if we're gonna lose, we got a chance to win every game. You know, that feels good. Not that we're gonna win every game. We 5-2. I ain't gonna boast. Shout out to the Knicks. They 1-1. We could have been 2-0 if RJ Barrett would have gave that rock up. See that game?
I ain't seen it at all.
Oh man, he gave us 20 the next game. Uh-huh. With that game in overtime,
he said, "I'm gonna make a name for myself this game one." He went coast to coast 4 times in a row, all ball of Nancy, am I lying? In overtime.
Terrible.
Cam Reds, that's the best game I ever seen him play in my whole life.
Yeah, Cam got some approval this year.
Yes, contract year.
Yeah. I don't like nobody.
Yo, I
know.
I seen the Knicks go in there.
There you go.
My man was killing. You know, I love Julius Randle. Leave him alone. Last year, he didn't know how to treat the New York fans. He didn't know he had never been a big marketplace like this and been a star. Now he know, keep his mouth shut.
Suck everything up and just be productive on the court.
Yeah.
Let your game do the talking, not your mouth. In New York, you talk about you get hurt.
He had beef with the fans for a little bit.
Didn't he?
Yeah, he did.
Right now, he coming along all right. That's what I like about him. I really like him.
I'm happy they didn't make that trade. I'm happy they kept everybody, the young team, together. They got stuff from the ground up. Everybody
I respect that. I felt a little different the other day.
You got to build it from the ground up.
I respect that.
You got to. That's how Golden State did it. That's how Memphis did it. That's what they good.
I'm going to believe in you.
Yeah.
So we should have got Donovan. I'm glad we didn't get with Donovan Mitchell. Glad we didn't get Donovan.
I gave up too much.
Okay. I respect that. Because the last two games I seen Donovan Mitchell, I was cursing the Knicks front office. Out. I'm telling you the truth. I'm seeing only bad thing I seen was he turned the ball over twice the other night.
Who's
the first time, Donovan Mitchell.
Okay.
But besides that,
he's a premier athlete. But I just
feel like, my God.
I mean, if it was me, I'd have stuff on the ground up.
I respect that because the Knicks forever been taking the old watch.
Gotta be patient.
Forever.
Gotta be patient.
Yeah.
In my opinion.
Yeah.
Gotta be patient.
Yeah.
I definitely respect that.
I'm gonna work with it, especially I got my man Julius Randle out there playing. But you know who got a lot of run yesterday for Orlando? I like the rookie of the year. I like him.
Oh boy, I forget his name. Pablo.
I like him.
Which one is the three?
I love that mic over there too.
There we go.
I like that. And who else I like? I like Oh, they had Bones out there playing, man. No disrespect to
Bones Holland.
Bones Howard is a killer for Denver.
No.
He played like he in 50-50 all day long. You never seen him?
He played with Denver.
Bones Howard. Oh, my God. He does all the 50-50 street moves. Bo. That's what I was talking about, though.
Yeah, from Orlando.
Looking better than Obama.
He's going to be good.
He's going to be good. I've been telling people, no disrespect to Shaquille O'Neal, son, but I always felt Bobo was a little better.
Yeah.
Not much, just a little. Sharif played stronger, but Bobo was just a little more athletic.
He crafty, he long.
He shoot that jumper.
He a good player to me.
I like Bobo.
He shoot the three.
Yeah. He gained a couple more pounds. He could stick around in the NBA. What do you think about Chet Holmgren?
I mean, don't get me wrong. I've always been a slim player, so I don't want to never hate on no slim basketball players.
Right.
But it's just about them tall players like
history
that.
History shows.
Not them foot injuries. Like, you just never know how. I never pray.
What do they call it?
I forgot what it's called, but them
playing fighters or something like that.
Like everybody to recover from them, like them injuries like that, and come back healthy.
Right. Yeah.
With this new technology, you never know. But I like Chet. Like I come from an era where you had to earn a name. I mean, so like you just let him give him like 3 years.
Yeah. See,
I don't
like
making projections. I mean,
right. You got a new kid out there, new high school kid. He's 7'4". I said, man, he's just gonna keep growing. He ain't gonna. This is his time to shine right now.
Victor.
Yeah,
okay.
His time is right now because at 7'4", that young man, he might get the growth disease. You know, when we wish the best for him.
You see, man, Lonzo ain't doing too good, man.
Who
hurt it again?
Yeah, what happened to him?
Yeah, something with his fragments or something.
He had to get surgery again.
For real?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Thank God he signed that contract last year. And his other brother in the league.
Melo got hurt though. Melo got hurt too.
Little brother.
Mm-hmm. And old boy playing good right now.
His other brother.
The younger brother got hurt. Melo got hurt.
LaMelo.
But old boy from forgetting his name from North, he went to NC State. Smith, Dennis Smith Jr. playing good.
Oh,
he is? Right
now. Oh,
he at? He in Charlotte.
They gave him another shot.
Playing good though.
Nice. Playing good. So he playing good.
He playing good right
now. I gotta check.
You know,
him out.
You know who I felt kind of bad for, and I think
Dennis Smith Jr. Meaning staying in the league.
Oh, right.
I don't feel happy for him. Who I thought could college would really help this game. He's had the same game as Dennis Smith Jr. and he's actually going to NC State.
Mm-hmm.
What's his name? God, I'm thinking. Jalen the Q.
Jalen the Q.
He didn't already forgot about him. He went from high school.
What year was
NBA, this? Maybe 3 years, 3-4 years ago.
Okay.
But see, one thing about basketball, when you short athleticism, I don't think that can carry you all the way. You have to be able to shoot the ball. You know what I'm saying?
No, for sure.
When you're tall, it helps you out better. Like Zion, we know he's super athletic.
But it's a different type of tall player now. Like you got a player that's a lot of the tall players now is finesse.
Right,
they're not really as like paint dominant like Zion.
No,
like even Anthony Davis, he kind of more finesse than Giannis. So it depends on like what type of like forwards and centers we talking about.
Right, because that's why I always get mad when they talk bad about Ben Simmons, how he don't shoot the ball, but Zion don't shoot the ball either. But he never did that.
Now he don't. No, well, no, Ben Simmons, I feel like he don't shoot the ball. At least Zion will shoot the ball.
I love you. You're right.
Yeah, it's a difference.
Uncle Weissman apologized.
Yeah, but with Ben, I just feel like it's all mental. Once he could get over that, if he could get over it, he'll be better.
Yes, yes. Well, let's get it on, man.
All this time.
That's right. Let's go.
And it was locked in.
They always coming.
Yes. 2 minutes. Your Instagram sometimes they cut us right off.
What?
Yeah.
Yeah. The gram don't play.
The other day I was on a live, and it just cut off. Like you try to come back on, but then I asked somebody else, and they live was acting up too. So I'm like, that's why we trying to push everybody, hopefully by New Year's, to YouTube.
Yeah. Okay, we'll do.
Honestly speaking,
like much as I was talking to y'all off the air, like we're talking about some real conscious stuff, but honestly, I never really even been on live. I never put my Instagram on live.
Wow.
I always just post.
Wow.
Nah, not at all.
Awesome.
Guarantee if you go live, you'll see your shit get flooded.
All right.
You'll have wild people in there.
You put your phone on,
never right?
Give it a shot. You got to give it a shot one day. All
right.
You'll see all the people that probably fans of you that you don't even know from all over the world.
Yeah.
And whether you're following and you got the blue check,
I guarantee you probably have
500,000.
Put your phone on.
Said, but my live, I like production.
Yeah, got you. Well, listen, we're gonna get this going. Let's see if y'all can hear this music. Can
they all want to be on all ball and Uncle White.
Yes, sir.
These guys want to come up on the show.
Hold on, listen. We have today a very special guest, New York song. But before we get started, we have all ball.
Uncle Ice, baby.
Hey, man. We got a special guest in the building, man. Well, how they do the music? How the Harlem Globetrotter music go? hey, listen. We have Harlem Globetrotter, New York City zone. Hey, man, we got my guy Cheese in the building, man.
Yes, that's love. Right. Thanks for having me, brother.
Yes, sir. How you feeling today, my brother?
Man, I'm feeling blessed, man. Thank you, man.
Yeah, man.
I appreciate it. Much love. I mean, honored to be here. I wanted to help. I mean, a group of brothers I see working hard. I mean, you never know who life you're touching with anything.
Yes, sir.
So I feel like it's about helping each other. Move forward, you know
what I mean? Yes, sir.
That's right.
Like I said, once again, we have Cheese from the Harlem Globetrotters in the building. He has an ill story. Like I said, he told us earlier, he got it out the mud.
That's right.
And I think his story is very important. Excuse my voice. I'm blaming Zay. I was supposed to be resting. I was on live this morning for 3 hours.
Disgusting.
Terrible. Ah, man, my guy, A Game Podcast in the building.
Shout out, Ron.
We have Harlem Globetrotters on Cheese and he has an ill story, and it needs to be heard. So let's get started. Tell us where you from and what age you started playing basketball.
Man, I'm gonna talk slow because it's a crazy journey. But started playing ball at 6 years old, but I really grew up just in a basketball community. Okay. Really, I wouldn't even be in the basketball world without my pops. My pops, Brawley Chisholm Jr., everybody in New York City know him as Big Brawls, legendary announcer from Kingdom to ABCD Camp, National Game, Nike Pro City for 20 years.
Legend, yes.
Like one of the top announcers in New York for the past, decades.
Right. I mean? Shout out to your dad for sure.
Respect, for sure. But he definitely put the ball in my crib, man. So,
okay.
Growing up in Brooklyn.
What part of Brooklyn?
Brooklyn.
That's right. Shout him out.
Street.
Huh?
I mean, but my mom and dad split up at a young age. So I used to always be uptown. My mom wasn't having me go outside too much in the 90s.
Right.
My pops let me roam around. So I grew up in the South Bronx a lot, 164 on Grand Avenue.
Okay.
Big
shout out to the BX.
For sure, all day. So that's why I really like hit the playground running like that at that point.
Okay, okay. Yeah. Yeah, well, like I said, once again, we got Cheese in the building, man. Like I said, Harlem Globetrotters on. Uncle Weiss, you got something you want to ask him?
Yeah, Cheese. Like, what high school you went to?
So, my story, like I said, like, first, I finished the story a little bit. So, like, growing up, like, elementary school, started out with Gauchos with Coach Dwayne.
Okay.
Okay.
And I started, left them, this is all at a young age, though, Super Biddies.
Right. Because Coach Dwayne, shout out to my man, boy, Coach Dwayne. Always had the U.
Then I went to Coach Durham player, Riverside Church.
Shout out to Coach Durham, the Harlem legend.
I'll make sure I give everybody their flowers today.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
After that, Bingo was there for a little bit for me.
Shout out to Bingo.
You played for legendary coaches. Go ahead.
For sure. After that, trying to see around middle school. I went to middle school in Queens, IS-119. Around middle school, I started playing for little teams in Harlem, like Team Rock.
Okay. I remember them.
And after that, I just started playing for Mr. Couch. And Mr. Couch, like, from middle school to through high school. And listen up, like, once I graduated from, like, IS-119 in Queens, my mom's ended up moving to Jersey.
Wow.
So my pops used to sacrifice his time all the time and, like, to pick me up from, exit 4 on the turnpike.
Right.
Wow.
To drive me back. Every Friday to Sunday, I'd be in the Bronx with him, just playing up, playing the street, playing the UDC, Gun Hill, Citywide, Abyssinian.
When you're in any tournament,
Coach Turtle,
put you
shout out to Coach Turtle, too.
Shout out to Coach Turtle. Turtle's a Harlem legend. Great, no, shout out to Coach Turtle.
And then just figuring my way out from there, man. I wasn't really on the circuit yet, but I was just playing for legendary coaches in the city.
Yeah. Learning the game.
So back to high school. So crazy thing is. So I went to Dwight Clinton High School for one day. My mom's like, you cover the jersey with me. So
what happened?
I took that side. I mean, my mom's a teacher. She wanted me to like
she knows what's up.
She know what's up.
Okay.
So like my pops wanted me to go to school in the Bronx, but you know how that goes. Different relationship issues.
Right.
But it was all love. But anyway, with the school in South Jersey, Cherokee High School. Linked up with some good people out there in Jersey. Jason Thompson, who played in the NBA for a long time.
Right.
Who else was out there? Kyle Hines.
Okay.
My man Mike Harry, who do real estate now. But at the time, man, like I had to just go where the ball was taking me.
Exactly.
So to kind of fast forward through there, my freshman year, I played freshman at Cherokee High School. My sophomore year, I didn't make the team because of my grades. I was wilding out because I didn't want to be out there.
Making adjustments.
I was like two black people on a team. Rebelling. It was different.
Right.
After that, I just was like, my pops got on me. Junior year, I made the team again, but I played JV. Still was coming here on the weekend, though. Hooping, playing in everything.
Got you.
Playing in Kingdom, playing in Dykeman. Shout out to Kenny Stevens and Isaiah. Played with them for a few minutes.
Okay.
My senior year, I didn't have no schools yet. I didn't take my SAT. I didn't take my ACT. I don't know. I was really bugging. And between all of that, my high school job I had from like eighth grade to like junior year, I was a water boy at Pro City. So I'm seeing all the pros from Charles Jones to Junie Sanders to Mookie to like all of those guys really like embraced me at a young age.
Okay.
So like, let alone I'm watching all these pros like, and let alone, like, my one of my, he like my uncle, Troy Truesdale, rest in peace.
I love Troy Truesdale.
took me under his wing at a young age. So I'm around all these legends, man. My pops had me around all these pros. That I was lucky, bro.
As he should.
To be like in a pro environment.
Yes, put you in a good environment.
At a young age to see like how to be a pro. So I know how to be a pro. Like just pro tactics, like how not to be late. Knowing how to act.
It's more than just playing.
How to act, more than playing.
Right.
And at the same time, I wasn't really the best player on my teams, man. I was usually like a role player. And I had times where I was the best person on my team, but I just knew how to get in while I fit in.
Exactly.
Okay. Funny story, man. Like I became a good jump shooter because the minutes I was getting, if I missed a shot, I was getting subbed out the game.
So it had to make the best of your minutes.
Right, so that really made me a good shooter. So right. Like, I knew like if I miss, I'm coming out. I got to cash shots out.
Right.
I'm making like now when I get my minutes now, like I know how to make 8. I know
got
how
you.
To make 9.
Right.
Like,
right.
So anyway, keep my story going. So after senior year, I didn't really know what I was going to do. I met up with a dude. Jim Couch helped me out a lot in this time. He linked me up with a guy by the name of Darwin Floyd. And I ended up going to prep school.
Right.
I ended up going to Genesis 1 Christian School. It's not even open no more. We was in the New York Times for like being like a like one of them like fraudulent schools. But we really was going to class. But it shut down after 3 years. But Genesis 1, we was top 10 in the nation. Shoot, my shooting guard, Varese Cloyd. Shout out to Varese, man. He went to Alabama. I played with Thomas Manzano.
Okay.
He was my two guard. Ed Berrios went to school with me. Afam Mujeki.
Okay. Legends, all legends, man.
I'm trying to see who else went to school with me. My center went to Arkansas, Mike Washington. But he from Arkansas. But anyway, prep school changed my life. It made me, I was ranked like top 100 in the nation at the time from Hoop Group. So I went prep for 2 years. I graduated when I was 17. And after that, I ended up just, I don't know, man, just following my dream.
Right.
I just love basketball, man. I didn't really know.
That's
where,
right.
I came this far, why give up? You know
what
I mean?
That's
right. So hold on, before you continue.
Yeah.
Like I said, your story is ill. And from a young age, your pops had you in the right position.
For sure.
Help, like I said, the people understand how important it is to have somebody that you look up to guide you the right way. Because it seemed like now, like I said, these days, these young kids, young men and women, if they don't have, whether it's a father figure, mother, just someone to guide them the right way, how important is that?
Can I rephrase that? I want to put it in a different form.
Sure.
Tell them how much is important for kids to listen to their parents.
Yeah.
How about that?
I think
that's what helps too.
Well, I think for one, for any kids watching and listening, I feel like definitely listen to your parents, you know, but ultimately, nobody can save you but you. I feel like you have to be the one to put the work in and you got to be the one to care about it. The one thing my parents didn't have to do for me was care about basketball. I feel like it was one thing, even if I didn't get paid for it, I would still do.
Right.
Like
right.
It's one thing, like, I just loved it. It's called, like, love the game, really. And I feel like that's important first.
Yes, sir.
Just find a passion that's yours, regardless of whatever it is. Like, if you want to be an artist, if you want to create a podcast, you want to be a YouTuber, you want to learn how to play the piano, whatever it might be for the young gunners, I would just say, man, just follow whatever that passion is and just got to ride it and just not give up. That's what it's all about.
My favorite word is hard work pay off, man.
For sure. The words sound cliche, but they're not. Like dedication.
That stuff can never get old, man.
Yeah. Sacrifice is real big.
Listen, in life, discipline, like you said, sacrifice. My father always says something, not being afraid to ask a question.
Not at all.
Those will get you far in life.
Yeah.
Once again, old boy with Uncle Weiss, man. We got the legend, Cheese, man, from the Harlem Globetrotters, man. Like I said, continue with your story.
Where was he at? Right out of high school.
So Genesis 1.
With the prep school.
Genesis 1 Christian School, man, really changed my life because it got me really just ranked. So at that point, I still can't pass my ACT, though. So that was really, like, triggering.
Right.
So I didn't know what I was going to do, so I went JUCO. So I went to Western Texas College in a small city called Snyder, Texas, man.
Shout out Texas. Hey, man.
Sure.
Get you an opportunity.
Yep. Yes, sir. I went there with my good friend from Queens, Derek Williams, and a dude from Brooklyn called Michael Thurgood. We all went to prep school together.
Okay.
So we just ended up just like, shoot, let's go to JUCO together.
Make it never run.
No, for sure. So my conference was heavy, man. Howard, Midland, Odessa, a lot of New York City talent was around at the time going to JUCO in that circuit.
Mm-hmm.
Still grinding it, man. Like, listen up. Ain't none of this guaranteed, man. Like, you going, you're making all these steps and all these sacrifices, but you don't know what's going to happen. I mean, that's right. Why I'm always humble to this day, because anybody could be in my spot. Like, it's not like, God is good.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Like, it's you one miss away from, like, but the one thing I would say, like, just be ready for your opportunities. That's really it. After JUCO, I had a couple schools. I had Cleveland State. I had St. Francis. I had, so really that's when everything kind of started bubbling for me. I got into my own. I got good late. I got good better around like 15.
Never. Yeah.
Like a little bit later.
Right.
A couple schools, like I had a couple schools started recruiting me, but I ended up going to Ball State University.
Okay, shout out Ball State.
Yeah, for sure. Ball State. Bonzi Wells, shout out to Bonzi.
Yeah, come on
OG
now.
OG there, took yes, me sir. Under his wing there.
Oh, yeah, you met Bonzi?
Oh, for sure. He scrimmaged against us every day there.
Legend. Shout out Bonzi Wells, man. Come on now. That's legendary. How was that scrimmaging with Bonzi? How tough was he?
We all know Bonzi. I mean, Bonzi always, I feel like he always got a bad rap in the league, but like at the end of the day, he was a mentor for me.
I like Bonzi well.
He always, he's a good ball player. I mean, he the real.
Yeah.
And he's a realist out of Muncie. I mean, at the same time, he took everybody in that era under his wing, from like just telling us how to move, how his trials and tribulations, his pros and cons, or how he was still a great dude to this day.
How about that?
Okay, shout out Bonzi, man.
But anyway, after Ball State, during Ball State, like the one thing I kind of want to talk about while I'm here for people listening, like things ain't always going to go your way. So I signed to a school where I'm not going to say like things didn't go my way there, but they really didn't go my way there.
Right.
Okay.
I got you.
I signed there and then I ended up like minutes was low.
Right.
Really playing, right.
But I always been a smart kid. Like I already got my scholarship. Let's graduate, Brawley.
Right.
Here you go.
Right.
But through this, it wasn't easy.
Right.
Like my junior year, I'm playing. We had like 30 plays, like 50 plays. Like I'm used to running and gunning.
Right.
So the memory wasn't bad. It was like a Princeton offense. I really wasn't with that. But it's cool. I mean, it is what it is. Ended up graduating with my communications degree.
Nice. Congratulations,
yeah,
man.
For sure.
That's awesome.
That's what it's about.
Yeah, for sure.
Come on, bro.
That's what it's about. Free education.
And then, like, from there, like, I came back home. Started playing just in Pro City. Because I already had lineage there.
Right,
so that's pretty much the only thing I was playing in. But playing against good pros like Andre Barrett.
Shout out Barrett. Legend.
This is when Sid Jones was around. Rest in peace, Sid Jones. I played with the Uptowners. I played with Jim Couch. Came home that summer. Still didn't really know what I was going to do. But I used to just go work out with... I used to take the train from the Bronx, yo, from Yankee Stadium all the way to Babylon.
Damn.
To the Long Island Railroad every morning. I had to be there at 8 in the morning to play with...
For the love of the game, man.
Yeah, for sure. For sure. Nice.
Keep you focused.
Had to take a train there by myself. Just get there. But every morning I had to be there. Work out. Just not knowing where all that's going to lead me, y'all. Like, not at all.
Right.
I was trying to go overseas. I knew the league was over with because my stats wasn't good because of Ball State. So I was like, you know what? Let me just go overseas. Try to play, like, in workouts and tryouts.
Right.
But I kept people close to me. Like, Mr. Couch kept James Ryan close to me. I had a good circle. Troy, rest in peace, Troy, was really close to me in that time. But I didn't know what was going to happen next with my pops. Yeah, visionary. He said, yo, just get your passport. You might be working at the movie theater, but yo, just get your passport just in case if anything happened. But anyway,
I love your dad, man.
I'm just happy at that time. But I was playing in Pro City. I had a good summer that year in Pro City. I was averaging like 20, but like just not knowing what's gonna happen next.
Right.
But anyway. I asked James Ryan, I'll never forget this. I asked James Ryan, yo, like, it was at the end of the summer. And I'm like, yo, James, when's the next Globetrotter tryout? He said, it's tomorrow.
Wow.
I'm like, dang, all right. So, like, I ended up going to the tryout off of James Ryan. And from there, the rest was history. I went to this tryout, and, like, the Globetrotter, I think, is all tricks, but the tryout, they just dropped the ball out there. We were just hooping for hours.
Right.
In this old high school gym in Long Island. And I played well, man. Like, I really just, like, I just played well. I was the first person they called in for an interview.
Good. Nice. Congratulations. Yes. Nice. Nice.
And then from there, I was like, I'm already prepped. I already know how to do media.
Right.
I already
right.
know how to talk on a microphone. So like anything that's going to be on camera, I feel like I'm confident in.
Right.
Right.
And from there, with the training camp, and I wasn't even signed yet. So they had this, it was so funny. Everybody had numbers on their back. And I was like, what are these numbers for? I ain't had no number. I'm like, I'm not on a team yet.
Right.
So from a Monday to a Friday, let's say training camp was from on a Monday. I was just hooping. They had all the new rookies go against, I guess, like us. We was like, they call us like taxi players, where it's like, you come in if somebody get hurt. So I don't think I really was on the team yet, but they had the rookies playing against me. So I thought I was just killing them. So they actually fired somebody for me. I guess just for my personality.
Right. They was tired. Like, they was ready to get rid of it. Soon as we get somebody.
Then from that Friday, they offered me a contract. I signed it. And then that's 12 years ago.
Nice.
So you've been playing down 12 years?
Yeah, 12
wow.
years.
Nice. Man, listen, how all ball with Uncle Weiss, man, Harlem Globetrotter, cheese is in the building.
Yes, much love.
Before we fast forward to the Globetrotters, let me ask you a question. Because
mm-hmm.
it seemed like you've been around the mm-hmm. basketball world.
Mm-hmm.
In your era, when you was out here playing, who was tough to play against, and name some of the players you played with that was tough?
A lot. I mean, that's definitely, I could name a few names, but a lot of people, man.
Hey, run some of them names up. That's what they be wanting
to hear. Edgar Sosa was the hottest in the city when I came up.
Right. Okay. High school, tough.
Edgar, shout out to Edgar.
He was the hottest in the city at the time. I had a good chance to play with Rob Thomas growing up.
Rob Thomas was a killer.
Keewon Smith.
Mm-hmm.
This is just me just rambling off the top right now.
Those guys are killers. Cook over Carpers.
Will Harris.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
He went to Virginia.
Mm-hmm.
That's off the top of my head. That was really, I mean, it was a good place for basketball at the time, man.
Always. Like, New York City. Always.
No, for sure. For sure.
Now, like, then we're always at the top of the market, man.
I feel like it. But what separated me at the time, that was like when AI Marbury was out. So everybody wanted to wear number 3.
Yeah.
Right. And everybody it wanted to have a handle. But
jump shot.
But my jump shot was what separated me. I feel like, and it got me to make teams.
There you go.
And like, humbly speaking, man, like playing against all these top tier talent and you grow up. And like, that's why I say like, You never know when your time is going
to
be there
ball.
For you.
Right, right.
Like
right.
All this time, like if I played on a team, like I wasn't, especially if I'm playing for a top tier team, like I'm definitely coming off the bench.
I love you.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I got to play my role.
Right.
You know what I mean? But it all raised my confidence. So by the time I got the JUCO, I'm starting.
Got you. Yeah.
So all that prepped me and helped me and conformed me until. So it was my time to be the man.
You want to be a good player, you got to play against good competition.
No, for sure.
That's how it go.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Let me ask you a question. Uncle, you want to ask him something?
Nah.
Yes. Let me ask him a question.
I want to ask him a question.
Yeah. I love jump shots.
Oh, yeah.
You being a jump shooter.
For sure.
Are you born with it, or can you learn to get a great jump shot?
I think both. You definitely could work on it, but I think it's all about, like, the timing of it. Like, if you already, like, 17 or something, I would say like start working on start crafting on a different skill. Like you can still learn. Like I guess what I'm trying to say is like I got my jump shot just by working on it, but like I still practice it. Like I don't know. Like some players, what you think? That's a tough question.
I think you can work on it because we see it every day in the NBA. Hey.
But they ain't sharpshooters, though.
They don't got to be sharpshooters.
Yes, you do. Shooters and sharpshooters, I feel like.
Listen, in the NBA, the average three-point shooter is, what, 33%?
Yeah.
So if you shoot, it's 35? Yeah. So anything above 35 is decent. Listen, that's not too hard, man. That's not too hard. It all depends on how many three-pointers you're taking, too.
I'm not even talking about three. See, my thing is, I'm not only talking about the three-point shot.
It's a jump shot in general?
Uh-huh.
I'm saying.
You can learn that.
I think you can learn it.
Like I don't want to say his name right now to continue to bash him, but let's just say Ben Simmons, for example, right?
Yeah.
He could learn how to shoot, right? He can learn
all
how to
day
shoot,
long.
But I don't think he ever gonna be a shooter.
Let me just Kidd.
You follow what I'm saying? Jason Kidd learned how to shoot.
And he was one of the top 3-point shooters in the NBA.
He was.
Right now.
He was.
So with somebody like Steph Curry, leave him alone after this.
Yeah.
You're born with that. And maybe the hard work get you over the hump.
So his, wait a minute. I think his jump shot is different, though.
Wait a minute, man.
His jump shot is different.
You know why?
I'm asking you a jump shooter. Go ahead, boys.
Because Steph puts the work in that y'all don't see. Now, I watched his game. I'm going to tell you who game is similar to them, similar to his, and his work ethics on the court. That's why he's a killer. Bradley Beal. Bradley Beal never stopped moving. Steph Curry, they never stopped moving. They never stopped. They use their feet. They use their legs on their jump shots. And always moving.
But also Bradley muscle memory. Always like, moving. Gilbert Arenas was a good shooter. Like, it's a lot of good shooters in the, that's been around. Like,
Back in the days.
I didn't even see Elgin Baylor, great scorer.
Oh, man.
Like, you got to understand, like, take him out of that element. Let me see if you can make 20 in a row.
You know who's a good shooter?
Let me see if you can make 30 in a row.
You know who's
you follow what I'm saying? Like, like, I'm talking about, like, just, you got to understand, like, a lot, like, I think Pat Bev said it. Like, you're going from some players in the league going from, or even just pro, it's not to say the league, just being a pro player, because it's players overseas right now, too. Internationally,
all over.
Just basketball as a pro.
Right.
Some players are going from averaging 40 in high school and 30 in high school to just being a defensive player. You know how hard that is?
That's not easy. That's
great point. Great point.
So what I'm saying is, like,
you could go from
averaging 10 points in high school to being
the man,
to being the shooter on the team.
Yeah.
Like, you follow what I'm saying?
So great point.
It's all about your opportunity given to you.
This one's taken way back, but you guys look older than y'all. This guy averaged 41 in college, man.
Who's this?
Pistol Pete.
Oh,
it wasn't no 3-pointers.
Yeah.
It wasn't no three pointers.
Yeah.
That guy had a gun, man. He was
getting way ahead
of his time.
Yeah. Pistol Pete Maverick. Yeah.
Yes.
Once again, man, all ball with Uncle Weiss. We got the legend Cheese in the building. Now,
much love.
The Harlem Globetrotters, people don't understand how legendary in the history of the Harlem Globetrotters.
Yeah.
At one time, didn't they beat a ABA or NBA team, right?
No, for sure. The Minneapolis Lakers twice.
Right.
When it was the world champions. Yeah.
Right.
A lot of good history, man. Started in 1926, all black team.
Yes.
Jamario Moon, NBA player with the Globetrotters. Magic Johnson played with the Globetrotters for a little bit.
Wow.
Wilt Chamberlain was the Harlem Globetrotters.
These are things people don't know. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Now you're good. But me personally, I learned a lot of history just being on a team. So that's kind of like, I'm kind of more seasoned with it. But I just feel like we get it's misconstrued as far as what the Globetrotters provide. Like to me, like, we're doing so much service, like, around the world. Like, for instance, like, just being, we call ourselves goodwill ambassadors of basketball. Like, we just, like, all I want to do now, bro, other than playing, is just is share, bro, and motivate kids to believe in themselves.
That's priceless.
That basketball, like, let's not use it as a tool that what it is. Like, you just, like I always want to make sure people keep that kid in them about the sport.
Right.
Because once you get paid for it, it kind of could change sometimes. But if you remember, like, kind of why you started doing it.
Love.
And, like, never forgetting why you did it. Like you said, like, it's like loving the game.
Yeah.
And, like, I never forget a story. I met Muhammad Ali when I was my barbershop growing up was on 116th and Lennox Avenue.
Okay.
Right there by the mosque and everything.
Yeah. Jimbo and all that.
Yeah,
right there. Still right there.
Yeah, still there.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Shout out to Chisholm III. He's still in there. Muhammad Ali came in there one time. It was me and my dad in there. And Muhammad Ali kissed me on the forehead and gave me a hug and his autograph. I lost his autograph though.
Oh, how you do that? Man. Go ahead though.
But the thing that inspired me the most was just his small impact in me. That little seed of, like, that's why I don't see how some players, like, turn down autographs and, like, in their life. Or, like, because, like, of course you can't do 1,000. Like, of course, it's kind of OD.
Right.
But, like, as Globetrotters, it's like, that's our service. Our service is, like, just, I remember being that kid, man.
Yeah.
Like, I'd be at Pro City and Stephon Marbury. I ain't going to lie. He never turned down an autograph for me.
Shout out Stephon Marbury.
Ray for Austin signed my basketball 3 times.
Shout out Skip.
And that's right. Like, back to back. Mm-hmm. Like, Right. Back to back. Like, he could have said, like, nah, I see you OD'ing a little, bro. Not for real.
And he appreciated the love.
Not for sure.
Sharing is caring.
Ron Artest never turned down an autograph.
I love the true warrior, man.
So, like all of those, all of those things, as a kid, on a bubble, like, it's instilled in me.
Right.
And I feel like as a globetrotter, that's what we do when we travel in the world, man. 60 countries I've been to. I played in every NBA arena.
Wow. Priceless. See the world.
Ni hao, wo jiao, Brawley. I've been to China. Come I had a Belgian
crazy,
waffle.
Crazy.
In
yeah, y'all him. Crazy. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Turkish bath or Turkey. But like, basketball is a universal sport. So like, we could play in different countries and not know the language. That's how beautiful our sport is.
Basketball bring y'all together.
We could play basketball and not even speak.
Yeah.
Mandarin.
In the red, yeah.
Like, we just hooping, making them laugh. Anthony's on the court. But going back to the globetrotter history, like, the entertainment part is definitely what separates us from, like, Curly Neal, the late great Marcus Haynes.
I've seen them all.
Metalog Lemon.
Metalog Lemon, love him.
So it's like me just being, like, a class clown on the court.
Right.
Getting paid for it, as well as, like, showcasing my skills. But it's just a balance you have to have.
Okay.
To stay competitive.
Right.
But also, I've seen on your page, one of your posts, you were saying when you first got there, you didn't know how to do the tricks yet.
Explain
how the hard work and how difficult that was to learn all that stuff.
Yo, I grew up as a straight hooper, so that, and I commend those guys that are like, let's say like Speedy Williams, that's like Future, that's like that always that already had that basketball wizardry in them. Going back to the Nike commercial, like growing up seeing that, Handles Franklin, like guys like that you see, but I was like, dang,
Mike
like,
Boogie's,
I ain't doing none of that.
Alley Moles, Sam Guard,
for sure. Like,
you know, those
I was in a straight jab, pull up, jump shot, make a shot, get back on defense.
Right.
But the wizardry and like, that's what sells tickets. That's what made you go out there to 55th to go watch.
Exactly.
Yeah. You know what I mean?
That's right.
Those guys are definitely special. But I learned my tricks from a guy from New York. Kenny Rodriguez.
Shout out to Kenny Rodriguez.
Trickster with the basketball. He was already on the team. So I just went to him every day. Go to his hotel room. Yo, teach me how to spin the ball.
Wow.
Teach me how to do this. Teach me how to do that. So now I got a little bit of tricks in my bag.
On top
of hooping. But one thing I never wanted to do was just convert all the way over, because like, I always knew I always wanted to kind of stay a hooper.
Right. You didn't want to be just like a trickster.
There's nothing wrong with that. It's people, is you can make a lot of money for just being a world trickster, you know what I mean? I'm not knocking that at all.
Right.
But I always kept my balance in between, where like, I knew, like, I guess I always wanted to keep my skill.
Right.
Not to say, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But Kenny Rodriguez, Sunday games and all that. For what are you talking about?
But Kenny Rodriguez taught me my tricks. A guy out of Brooklyn, Dante Harrison, taught me my tricks. And I guess that was the rest of it. Anyway, I mean, you could keep asking me. I don't want to keep rambling.
No. Listen, like I said, once again, this platform, me, All Ball, and Uncle Weiss, this platform is for guys like you, for the people that want to listen and learn. Yeah. Like I said, I don't understand, just me personally.
Yeah.
We have a lot of legends, and you're a legend. Mm-hmm. And I feel y'all deserve platforms to give y'all story, because there's a lot of young men and women that don't understand the history of, like I said, the Harlem Globetrotters.
Yeah.
Or just the history of a lot of New York City basketball in general.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I feel like another message I want to get out there is the fact of the thing about our sport, all ball, basketball, is that it's so many avenues. We different than football. We different than baseball. Because when you graduate as a football player, if you don't make the NFL, you could probably go to Canada.
Ain't that many opportunities.
They got some leagues in Germany.
Yeah.
But with basketball, man, you can make top dollar in Spain, in China, in Germany.
Yes. There's
more opportunity for basketball.
Okay.
So like, I made a living. I made an opportunity with the Harlem Globetrotters.
Right.
I mean, beautiful. So like, what I'm saying is like,
that opened up other doors. For
I
you.
Feel like, as basketball players, we need to open our minds to like, knowing like, yo, bro. Of course, it's about this bag. Like we sacrificing all this time on this sport. Years
of hard work.
Years of hard work.
Like, if you
gotta get that back somewhere.
Right. You go to the league, you get some money.
That's a fact.
You gotta get that back.
You still enjoying the game.
And I'm still traveling the world doing what I love to do. I'm inspiring kids. I made a career out of this. And I feel like I feel like it's special to me.
It is.
Bro, no,
it ain't only the kids you watch.
Right,
watch
man. Come on, bro. We commend brothers like you, man, that's out there doing a great service.
You're
positive.
Role model.
Yeah, come
appreciate
on, man.
Role model,
yeah, baby. Yeah. Let me ask you a question.
For sure.
What country is, what's the best country you went to as far as basketball-wise that just embraced y'all and went crazy?
Ah, man, good question. Definitely, my top is definitely, I would say, Spain. They go crazy, man. Uno foto.
Uno foto.
At the end, they're going crazy, man. 40,000 fans.
Awesome.
Wow. Australia loves basketball.
Nice.
Italy.
My boys in
the Corey Williams too.
Some people.
My boys
that
got a program out in Australia. West Australia.
The Wolverines.
Okay.
Yeah. West Australia,
West City,
yes.
Australia.
Yeah, okay. they on the ground with us.
Yeah, Corey out there killing it again, killing the game too.
Yeah,
Homicide.
Like the Stephen A. Smith out there.
It said Corey Fisher.
He turned that into ESPN.
No, but he's doing, he's killing it out there.
He is killing
Let's
them over
go.
There.
You can't eat here, eat somewhere else.
Shout out Homicide.
But that's what I'm saying. Like, so like, we have to like, well, sometimes it might be too late for us, right? So peep this. So if you have kids right now, I don't have kids yet, right?
Yeah, I have.
So it's our job to kind of teach. And give them, open their mind at a young age, bro.
Right.
Like have them learn how to do graphic design.
Right.
Have them, because they can learn how to set up shop like you doing at home.
Right.
Like it's about having other traits while being a basketball player. Like when I was young, my dad had me in acting classes. I didn't know it was going to help me.
Right.
To this day.
Right.
My dad had me, my mom had me in different programs learning how to public speak. Right. I didn't know it was going to help me today. So I commend my parents for that for sure. But you just never know. Like you want to have as many. It's like Neo in the Matrix. You know, every time he got the has so many, he knew how to do karate. He knew how to
the jack of all trades.
That's why he was the one. Yeah. You know what I mean? So like you want to have as many trades as possible.
Yeah, jack of all trades, man.
Yes, sir. Once again, man, Harlem Globetrotter Zone, man. Cheese, man. We really appreciate you in the building. All Ball Uncle X. Before you get out of here,
For sure.
Action. We always ask. You already know we're gonna ask him.
Hit him with it.
We your top five greatest of all time.
Oh man! All right.
Come on now.
I would say Michael Jordan. Let's get out of the way.
Okay, that's right. One.
Let's get that out of the way. Shaquille O'Neal.
Two.
This is my era too. So
any era was good for us. Give me your five.
Yeah. I'm gonna say Magic, because he changed the game.
Three. Yeah, come on now.
I'm not trying to have nobody hate on me. Let's throw LeBron in there.
Yeah, all right, LeBron.
Listen,
pick who you want to pick, man.
I'm going to hate on you. Bet that. Go ahead. That's LeBron all. In there. I disagree, but you family, so it's all good. Go ahead, that's four.
And I'm going to say rest in peace, Bill Russell.
Okay. That was the big Bill, man. Yeah, 11 of those, right?
Yeah, 11.
Yeah.
What, he had 9 straight or something crazy like that?
He had 11 chips. I don't know how 11. Many straight or not. But. Yeah. Reason why I say that, man, they offer different reasons. Reason why, because definitely civil rights with Bill Russell.
Like, a lot.
Great
like,
point.
I
Great
feel
point.
Like he did so much off the court that just he got to be in there.
Right.
It continues.
I feel like with LeBron, he's statistically, there's no arguing it, especially when he's about to beat Kareem this year.
Facts.
All the statistics.
So like they feel like they all kind of changed. I mean, if I had to throw a six man, I mean, Steph Curry changed the game too. But
yes, he did.
What's I said? I said
you said Magic. Said Magic.
So
Mike.
With Magic, I feel like he was the first face of the league, like with the smile, with the brand in the league.
Yeah.
It was Cody in there.
Yeah.
Larry Bird.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
All day long. They saved
it.
But
I felt like Magic was Coca-Cola. Magic was like
Showtime.
He was Showtime.
Yeah.
Larry
yeah.
Bird was laid back.
Good point.
Jordan was like the first brand in the league to make it national and make it like only dude still selling sneakers at like a Hot Pocket.
Ridiculous. Yeah.
So like to me, I picked him for all
before
different reasons.
Before Jordan, you know who was selling sneakers, right?
Dr. J.
Converse, the Doc.
My other brothers, hold on. Clyde.
Clyde Drexler had
Pumas.
Clyde had the Pumas.
Clyde Frazier. And
McAdoo had the ponies.
Yeah. I know my history. You can't forget about.
From my brother, they sneakers.
You can't forget about ProCast. ProCast was fire back then.
Yeah. Facts. ProCast.
They had a sponsor.
Mm-hmm. ProCast ain't had no sponsor. Wasn't nobody wearing ProCast?
Yeah,
listen, man,
I go load the ProCast, man. It was PS Flyers. I ain't wear those. We ain't had to. The brothers were wearing PS Flyers. Y'all knew who y'all was.
Smoke Webb was in the dunking contest. He had on low top Tonics or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, man. That's how great some boots was.
No, for sure. Sneakers definitely changed. It's definitely like a big market for them now. So I feel like Jordan did that.
Right.
Who's sneakers still selling? And he been stopped playing sports.
Besides Mike. A few people. Scotty.
Bo Jackson.
Yeah, a few people, King though. Griffey's. Penny.
Yeah, Penny. Griffey's.
When they come out.
When the Barclays come out.
Yeah, they show the Barclays back out.
Those dresses
fire. Yeah.
Yeah, it's a few.
Yeah.
I love sneakers, though. I mean, bring back only got to stay fly.
Bring them back the same cheap price. It was expensive then. Now listen up, man.
Inflation is getting us right now.
Y'all, yeah, it's tough.
Save that money, y'all.
Yeah, it's tough. It's tough. But listen, man, we're going to get out of here, man. We appreciate my guy Cheese in the building, man. Yeah, like, man. I said, man.
One more.
Busy. Go ahead. What you want to ask?
Yeah, what's up?
Last question.
Who's your NBA team? You're a Knicks fan? Who you like?
It's like Jadakiss said, I'm from New York, but I've never been a fan
of the
Knicks.
Who your team then, man?
Listen, I like players, man.
Come
like,
on, because this is the Knicks platform right here.
Hold on, hold on.
All ball no lights love the Knicks.
Hold on.
So, like, look, my dad, right? This dude love the Knicks. He think everybody that get on the trading block be like, he should come to the Knicks. Like, so peep this, though. Like, why root for it? Them dudes ain't winning my whole life.
Hate you.
Wow, I'm like, why root for them?
Go ahead.
Why root for them? They just won't let me, like, listen up. They got to
win one in my lifetime. That's why.
That's stressing me out. I'm good, man.
They won in my lifetime.
He said they got to win first, and then I'll be a fan.
Yeah, let them win first, man.
So before we get you out of here, Uncle Weiss was about to say it.
Yeah.
Who you like in the league today? You said you like the players. Give me your top five right now.
I like Steph for sure. I like Dame Lillard.
I love Dame.
Hold on. Go ahead. I'm going to let you start finish your five, but I'm going to ask you something. Yeah, go ahead.
I like Steph. I like Dame. I like KD.
I love KD.
I like John Morant.
I love John. Yeah. Like, Must-see TV?
Yeah, for sure. Yes. I like Jason Tatum.
I love him,
yes,
too.
Yes.
I can keep going. I just like players,
your name five already.
Like listen, players. No, you can listen.
You love the game.
Now, I want to say this.
Jason Tatum can be shaking this year,
baby. Or we get out of here.
He ready to go. Sorry, yeah.
They forgot who Dame Lillard was, man.
Oh, you love Dame. You seen the other night. The last two nights you've been going crazy.
This is my opinion. Mm-hmm. They forgot who Dame Lillard was.
Out of sight, out of mind.
He's coming back with a vengeance. Mm-hmm. So this is how I feel. I think he's going to be in the MVP race this year.
I think it's if he stay consistent and they got to win. I think if they make one more piece, a trade, bring another piece over there. He just needs like a little bit of help more offensively. No. If they could get somebody to take a little bit more pressure off of him, he's going to be straight and ready for the playoffs. Yeah. But as far as he can handle right now, he's starting off great.
I just want to say,
he's loyal. I like the loyalty and what he's doing. I like people keep saying he's going to diminish his career, but I feel like, honestly, like I feel like he's doing it on purpose. He's setting a precedent.
Right.
Let me say something. I came to terms with this, and this is the truth. This is why I say John Morant is separate. Yes, Uncle White's going to say it again. He didn't jump my man when he had 20. He had 49 the night before. He was tired. John Morant is separating himself from Trae Young and Luka. You know why? Because John Morant is like Dame Dollar. They're the only superstars on their team. Mm. They got other role players. Yeah, he got Jared Jackson. Mm. Those guys are role players. These guys are one-man wrecking crew. Under 6'4", and they giving the NBA more than they can handle. But
Uncle Ice, I agree and disagree with that statement just because I feel like with Ja, they got a solid team. I'm be honest with you, they got Baines.
They win better.
But remember when he got hurt, they were still winning games.
Don't let Uncle Ice tell you their record.
No,
24-3 without him.
I respect all of that. What I'm saying is like usually teams when they lose. They got a good collective,
right?
And Ja just put them over the top,
right?
Like, Ja's their superstar, but I wish, like, let's say Dame had that same setup, might win a chip,
right?
Sometime at the front office,
yes, yeah.
True. Who had the same setup?
Dame. They got a center out there. Yeah. I like the center.
Yeah,
you a couple more plays.
You see, I'm smiling because I was arguing. You hear my voice? I was arguing all morning on live.
Yeah,
all morning. Hey, we gonna get out on that high note.
Yeah.
Hey man, Cheese, appreciate you, my brother, man.
Thank you, Uncle Ice.
Shout out to my man, Cheese.
I do want to say one thing before I bounce. I want to say thank you for what you guys are doing. I mean, continuing to spread the joy and the positivity within basketball.
Yes.
And thanks for having me, man. Seriously.
Hey man, anytime, my man. Old boy with Uncle Ice, Harlem Grove Trotter Zone, man. Cheese, man, in the building. Much love, yes sir.
Shout out to Cheese, man.
Yeah, man, appreciate it, my brother. Thank you, man.
That was nice, man. Hey. I'm glad that you gave your father his flowers.
Oh, I got you. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, yeah.
Got to.
That's what I'm talking. I respect that. I appreciate you. I know.